Hello there and welcome to another Walker Analytics video. I'm Wesley Walker, the founder and director of Walker Analytics. And today's video, I'm going to tell you one trick that I used that ended up helping me get my job as a lead analyst. But before we begin, if any of you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe for more analytics, careers and advice and tutorial videos, and drop a like down below if you found this useful. So while I was looking for a job hunt, I did quite a lot of different things to kind of help me get better feedback from my employers, potential employers. And one thing that I did, which ended up helping me get a good response and actual offers from two companies, was that I did a full deep dive. I did an investigative analysis into their website's performance. So to give you some context, I was looking for roles as a senior lead or digital analytics manager. And I had quite a few interviews at some really big UK retailers, travel agencies, and some big companies. And the first place that I went to see, I did them a mini presentation deck looking into their website's traffic mix. So I looked at their device mix, their site speed, and their share of organic and paid traffic, etc. And I sourced all of this data from a tool called SimilarWeb, which you can get for free as a Chrome extension, and it will tell you a couple of key figures on any website that you visit. I use some of those stats to help with my case. I also use data from what's known as the Google Chrome UX report, which provides you with device data, but also provides you a lot of speed data as well, to provide you on what the average percentage of users who fall into a fast or a medium or a slow experience, and their bandwidth. And it gives you a lot of really good detailed insights, so you can get into pretty much most of the websites on the web. And to give you a bit more context, the Chrome UX report is essentially anyone who uses Google Chrome, when you agree to using the terms and conditions, they use your sessions through Google Chrome and they store that data, and they provide an anonymous data warehouse where you can actually go into any website, like night.com for example, and you can see what the percentage of people who had a fast, slow, or medium experience was, and how many people were mobile versus desktop on the website, and anyone can get access to this data. But I grabbed all of that digital data and I put it into a presentation for them, and I showed them, you know, this is how they're comparing against their competitors, this is what their traffic mix was, and it blew them away because they weren't expecting it. And I did this in a way where I let them ask me all the questions first. So we went through the normal interview, they asked me questions about my experience, I answered the questions back. And then when the interview was about to finish, I said, well, I've actually prepared this presentation deck for you guys, do you want to see it? And they said yes. And I opened a presentation and I talked them through it, and it blew them away. And they actually asked me to send them the presentation afterwards so they could do their own, do some more investigation into it afterwards and potentially take some actions, which I thought was pretty good because it clearly showed that the effort that I put into it worked. And in the first place I did that, they gave me an offer, but the offer wasn't what I was looking for at the time, so I chose not to accept it. And then the next place I did the same thing. So I did the deep dive and I showed them the competitors, and I even added a moving line graph, which were really trendy at the time. When I showed them that absolutely blew their mind. But I did that using the Chrome UX data and showed them against their competitors and how fast they were versus the others and their device mix and so on and so forth. And they verified it, they saw it. And because the SimilarWeb device mix data is quite close to what you typically see in GA, they saw it and they verified it, said, yeah, this is pretty much where it's at. And I ended up getting the lead role there, which was a huge step in my career as an analyst, because I went from working within a team, a fantastic team, which was great, and I learned lots from them, to then having to be self-reliant, having to learn on the job a lot, which really pushed me forward as an analyst and an individual as well. And I never looked back on that decision. But that's essentially it. So if you guys are out here and you're looking for your first job in analytics, or maybe you're looking for a level up position as an analyst, I highly recommend, of course, doing your standard research on the company, their values, what they're about, and preparing answers for all the questions. But also, if you can get some extra data, whether it be based on digital data that I've provided you in this video, or you do some analysis on their stock price. If you do some kind of analysis on from whatever you can gather from the business, and you provide that in a mini presentation deck, and especially if they don't ask for it, it's going to blow them away. And if you can illustrate that, and if you can present it really well, then you're immediately showing to them that you can do the job and that you're a more than capable analyst who knows what they're doing and knows how to translate and transform raw data, unstructured or structured data, and present it in a story, which is what being a data analyst is all about. So I hope you guys found this video informative, and let me know if you did, and I'll be seeing you on my next video.